Getting Zafir back online. Sorry, guys.
So you hang up on me.
No,
because you didn't want to agree with me. Is that what we're doing now? Is that how you're feeling now, bro? You hang up on me when all of a sudden you don't agree with me. I told you. It's like you want to go. You all of a sudden now you just want to hang up the phone. Let me know how you really feel, fam. Let me know how you really feel, bro.
I swear to God, it ended at 9. I think live is only an hour. Like, I've never done this before, so I don't know personally.
I don't know, but what I am saying is that you hung up on me. Let's not change the topic. Let's not lose.
I'm giving you the reason why it happened.
You hung up on me. I'm just saying, you just straight hung up on me.
You have my girlfriend agreeing with you right now. This is not okay.
This is totally, you hung up on me. And I know what I'm saying? Now I see how she feels. I'm on your side. I'm on your side. He got an attitude problem, and he needs to fix it. You know what I'm saying? Because clearly, you just can't be hanging up on people when you feel some kind of way. You got to be an adult and listen to the other side of the situation. Now I'm fucking with you, fam.
Oh, shit. That was good. I could have said him anything. Like, I literally just ended. I was kind of like, what the hell just happened? So, whatever.
Yeah, it was like done. It was like, we're done.
All right, you guys have been enough, apparently. That was. I only had like a handful left. I mean, come on. They just kicking us off like that?
I'm saying, let's get the last bit. Let's get the last bit. Let's get them real quick. You know what I mean? Let's hear it through.
Yep, get through. The new episode just released too, so definitely go check that out. Guys,
It released at
9. It's out. It's there. And you're on the next one. If you start playing nice, I haven't recorded it yet, so I could easily I could bash the shit out of 3 a.m. I just hope you
know. Yo, let me know how you. Well, you're gonna. Well, clearly you have shown me that you're gonna let me know how you really feel, anyways. Well, so it doesn't even matter.
This has been fun. I'm glad we did this. I'm glad we had you on. This is great.
Yeah, man. This is dope. I'm excited. Fun. Like I said, I'm definitely excited to see what happens when we can get the listening party live. And seeing That'll how that really, goes. I think that's going to be dope. I think it's going to be real dope.
Joining us that wasn't with us earlier, Zafir is going to do a live listening party in a few weeks. We'll definitely, you know, roll out some promo for that and tell you guys when to tune in for his listening party. But he was absolute pleasure to have you on here for, you know, an hour, a little and more, right? I'm not kicking you off. It's okay.
Are
you okay? I'm okay.
But see, everybody who knows me knows that I'm an emotional fan. So you can't be doing that to me. You can't be playing with my emotions, hanging up phones on me and stuff.
You're right.
You know what I'm saying? You can't be doing that, dog. Like, you know what I mean? I get caught in my feelings like Drake. So you can't be doing that.
It happens to the best of us sometimes. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, my mistake. Like, I've never done live before. Now I know. Now I know after an hour, it's going to kick me off. So
heads up, you know, just let somebody know. That's all. Just let somebody know. Inform. Yeah, as part of communication.
I'll be sure that this is a learning curve. This is a learning thing for me. All right. So, but I'm telling you, you gotta obviously stop. My girlfriend. She's thank you for joining us. She's agreeing with you. Like now, this loses points on 3 a.m. when I review it.
this loses points.
It does. Sorry.
But one of the things I am thinking though, now that we've actually done this. And because I would want a lot of the listeners to have.
Before you said that, it's so anybody that misses this, I guess it's going to be saved. So I guess was able to save it. So just doing that.
Work.
We'll definitely be able to post this somewhere. But go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah. So I'm thinking like so when I do the listening party live, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to shoot out a kind of like a emailing list or something where I can get a list of people who are definitely going to like. Join the listening party live.
Yeah.
And what I think we're gonna do is I think I'm actually gonna send them the audio.
That could be
because my thing is that like I enjoy doing this and but I really want the listeners to get like the full sound of what you know what I mean? So like I'm just listening. I'm listening and learning, you know, and if there's supporters. If there's supporters and stuff like that, then I want to be able to give my supporters a gift because they're already going out their way backing me and like doing so much for me as they always do, which I'm grateful for. By the way, that's what my cup says.
I can't read it. It's flipped.
Says,
around.
it says thankful, grateful, blessed. You know, so that's my Sunday cup.
I like that.
So I think what I would want to do is do an emailing list, know who's going to come, and then maybe send out those WAV files ahead of time. So that way those people have it exclusively, and then we can go live sometime. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know. We'll figure it out.
I like that. Either way, thank you for this, choosing us as your platform for that. We are, like I said, you are all welcome to have a listening party at any time.
Well, you know what? We haven't done it yet. So maybe your attitude of hanging up on people is going to change that. I don't know. Okay. We'll see. It depends on how you give me 1-3 a.m. depends on whether or not I'm going to jump on here. You know what I mean? Like, it may not just be the right move for me. I don't really know. If you're here in this video because I'm here, go ahead and hit that heart button and let me know. Because the more hearts I see, then I'll be like, okay, so my peoples are here on this platform, which may mean that, I don't know. Maybe I got to do my listening party somewhere else. Wow. I'm going to hang up on people.
Wow. I'm just saying. I see how it is, man. I really do.
There go
all the hearts, man. Yeah, it's your people, I guess. So, but no, like I said, this can be your place. I know we joke around, you know what I'm saying? It's all love.
Always, you know, I'm be right here. I'm be right here.
Again, anybody that just joined us, make sure you check out Zafir's listening party, which will happen in a few weeks. Like I said, we'll roll out some promo. We'll definitely let you guys know when that's going to happen. If you are interested in being on this email list to hear the audio, the songs before they release, make sure you follow him at officially Zafir _.
Right. Appreciate you.
Oh, hey. Oh, shit.
There you go. Appreciate you.
He's my favorite, too. Back off. No, I'm just kidding. He can be your favorite as well. Zach, your comment didn't go unnoticed. She's real, I promise. But I didn't make up that I have a girlfriend. That wouldn't make sense. But yeah, no.
If you made it up live, it'd be super awkward.
Yeah, that would be awkward. I feel like.
Yeah.
Yeah, that wouldn't go over well. There's proof here. She's Zach, and I'm real. See, she's right there. What's up, Chris? Good job. Although, maybe try not to agree with him as much, because starting to get a little weird.
Let's get into these last tracks, bro.
Let's do it. Let's get after it. Speaking of Zach, he's had another one. Rod Wave. I've heard this guy's name floating around. The song is called Heart on Ice. I haven't heard a single song from him, so I don't know.
First of all, I gotta give a shout out to my man Cam.
Oh shit, what's up, Cam?
I have a sip, my man Cam. Yo, listen, man, there's very few people that I work with on a consistent basis. Cam is one person I work on a consistent basis. This man is a dope artist. He is consistent. So I got to give a shout out to my man's Cam, because he's on here. And Cam already knows that I haven't slept. I haven't slept since 88, bro. You already know that, fam. You already know.
Stop reusing the same lines you used on the first episode. All right?
But it's the truth. But he asked me the question, and he knows. it's not reused, because if I had changed the answer, then you would know I'm lying. But it's a consistent answer, which means it's the truth. I haven't slept since 88. You already know what it is, bro.
Yeah, no, like I said, we well know aware that you don't sleep, so. Okay. God willing. No, excuse me. I'm sorry. Heart on Ice. Rod Wave.
Let's get it. Heart on Ice.
Trying not
to get in my feelings. Thinking of a way I can make these millions. Maybe that'll take this pain away and clear up all these rainy days. Heart been broke so many times. Don't know what to believe.
Yeah, yo. Pause that. The way this man holds on that word, yo, he got a voice on him. I mean, that's hands down, no question about it. But like, yo, this is dope. This is dope.
I don't know. Good job, Zach.
Zach
Rete. That's the second track that he sent us. So I put both.
Yo, listen, that's serious. Like, I'm glad I heard that. Like, he's a dope.
This is good. Yeah.
Yo, he's dope. Like, he's dope. And
he says the live version on YouTube is good. Zach, send that to us on DM.
You know something? I don't even doubt that. Like, just hearing how he was singing and how he was like on that. That's Corona baby making music. Yes, it is.
Good job, Laura.
Corona baby making music. That is baby making music. That's exactly what it is.
That and the weekend, the party next door. Those two.
Yo, albums. Listen, I don't know right now. Listen, Rod Wave might just have them all beat. Rod Wave, this is Corona baby making music. Rod Wave is on the new wave. Make your babies to Hard on Ice. Make your babies to Hard on Ice. This is crazy. Yo, listen. The way he was holding on to that note was so smooth, man. It was so smooth. That was dope. That's dope. Yeah, like
clearly we both were sleeping.
I'm and this is why I love doing things like this though, because like hearing new artists and doing this, like, this is dope, man. Like this opened up a whole thing for me. And like what I love about it is like he's his own thing a little bit. And what I mean by that is that he has that new era kind of voice as he's sick, like that new era sound kind of, but his voice is like, he's singing. You know what I mean? Like, it's very unique. It's singing. You could tell it's him. He has a little bit of that old school 90s influence on it, but it's completely new. It's spun almost off.
Like just genuine, jagged edge, like type, but.
Yo, listen.
Modern. Yeah.
I fucks with it heavy. That definitely got to follow.
That was good. That was good. B-Leafs just joined us. B-Leafs, good to see you, buddy. Join us. We already did Lifetime. Sorry you missed it. But, you know, it's on the new episode that's just released. And back to Rod Wave. I'm going to have to not only add this song, but definitely see what else he's got going because.
Yes. Kevin Gates. Juwan, you are 100%. Sounds like Kevin Gates. Yeah. You're absolutely right.
I actually think I like it better than Kevin Gates.
First of all, don't ever disrespect Kevin Gates. I just don't do that.
There's no disrespect. It's just being 100. I've never been the biggest Kevin Gates guy, just like on record. I had a roommate that was like infatuated with Kevin Gates, my boy T. He like, it was like his favorite. So. But no, I'm so glad I got to listen to this because this was good.
This is good. Rod Wave made my playlist, hands down. I fuss with that.
That was good. Yeah. We have a couple more. What They Do is the artist. What spelled WHUT?
Wait, hold on. The artist is what?
What They Do.
I'm sorry. Spell that again for me, please.
WHUT.
WHUT. Okay, so like woot. Okay,
but I think it's supposed to be what they do. I'm gonna call them What They Do.
Okay.
So this was a submission from another podcast. From
I have a question. You're a teacher, right?
Yeah.
We're gonna discuss how you feel about this later. But again, What They Do. Sped up me is what?
What Day D E Y.
Wow. Okay.
Well, and I teach English, so first of all, two very simple words being spelled wrong. I don't know. I'm not a huge. We'll see. Hopefully, the song is better than the spelling of the name. That's just my hope.
Ah, okay.
I've never. I think he's from Miami because I know the podcast. I've gone back and forth with the guy. I actually, you know, what's funny. I do like his music taste, so I'm curious to see. I actually did send him the B-Leafs. Shout out, you know, B-Leafs, you're here.
I'm not against that. It just threw me off when you said What They Do, and I'm like, is it really gonna be that? Because I was typing extra with an E, and extra had no E in it. You know, and I feel some kind of way because when I spell extra, I spell it with an E, with the extra lettering that, and I mean, it's not an extra, it's what comes with it. It's with the E, and it had no E in it. I don't know, that's a whole nother conversation, a whole nother thing, you know what I mean, like a whole nother way, but all right, what they do, we'll see what he do.
No, what they do.
Yeah, what they do, we're going to see what it do. We're going to see what it do. We're going to see what they do, We're going to see the whole damn thing. Let's get it. What song we listen to?
Ultimate High.
Okay. All right. I cannot explain. Soon as that melody with my brain got me open for a dosage. Now I'm time. Yo, what up, Paul?
Since 88.
Since that's the 88. Yo, Cam, if you post that video of me sleeping, I'm gonna be upset. My man. We're doing some music reviews right now. Listen to some music, doing some reviews. So stay on, though. Let me know what you think about the stuff we're playing right now.
Let us know how you guys feel about these songs in the comments. Absolutely. Join in on the conversation.
My God, man.
Okay, so this song is like 6 minutes long, so I'm not gonna bother playing the whole thing. But what did you think?
It's boom bap. That's kind of where I am with it. That's just
And when I say it, I want to keep
reiterating that I don't mean that in a bad or negative way. I mean, like, it just sits where it sits. It just is, like, you know what I mean? It's like, it would be no different if I was listening to something that, like, was like for like another vibe that everyone was playing over and over and over and over and over again. I would say the same thing. I'd be saying, oh, it's just this genre, like, it's like, it's just trap, you know what I mean? Like, it is very Styles P kind of vibe.
It almost gave me a Jurassic 5 vibe a bit too, and just like a bit in the with the instrumental
Styles hold on real quick, Styles P is way better, yes, but it does have that kind of vibe. I feel
I think so too. Again, I think I fit it in with Lifetime Beliefs, you know, Hero 16, the Loot track. What else was on here? The Actual Proof, God Willing, that was the other one that I think we said too. Those songs kind of fit on a playlist together, I think. Like, again,
they can.
Yeah.
They can. And I want to point out something that that Cam said, because we talk obviously music all the time when I'm speaking with Cam and stuff, but it's dope, but it's just not right now. You know what I mean? It's good music, but it's just not what's happening right now. And the thing about that is that, like, if you're an artist trying to come out right now and you're a boom bap artist, there's nothing wrong with that. But it is a genre that is shrinking, is very niche. You know, so you just have to make sure that or be aware of what you're getting into when you're jumping into that specific genre. So it's a dope song. Yeah, it's cool. It's boom bap. Like, it's smooth. It is, like, but it is, you know, it's just not happening right now. And because it's not happening right now, it does mean that less ears are going to fall on it, which means that it's going to kind of stay. And it's going to kind of stay in the background or stay within that niche of a group. So that's good.
Got two left here. The one of them is going to be Lovesick by Lil Nicky. We had a submission from him a couple of days ago. This is his song. He's a Boston guy. Let's see what he's got.
Lil Nicky?
Lil Nicky with two Ks. So, again, to go back to the spelling of some of these guys' names, to answer your question, Zafir, it does bother me a bit. Definitely spelling. But my biggest pet peeve, my students know this, anybody that's or former students that are in this right now, my biggest pet peeve is when people don't capitalize I. That is my biggest pet peeve. The spelling, I can deal with it as long as I can kind of see what you're trying to get at. Unless if it's a word like what. What should always be spelled correctly. I'm sorry. But the biggest thing for me is like I that's not capitalized. Like that drives me freaking bonkers, man. I'm not kidding. Like, I feel passionate about that.
So when I next time I text you, I'm going to text you a lowercase I. And then I'll let you know what I did with the extra time with me not hitting the capitalize button on that. All right.
Okay. Sounds good. Extra time with no E. All right.
Extra time with no E.
All right. Lovesick, Lil Nicky. Here we go.
Let's get it. Interesting.
Yeah.
Taylor Brothers, chicken flex. I just need one more chance with you. And we can be the ones that feel it talk about. Cause all we care about.
We both said okay at the same time. That's funny. All right. So, if the artist is listening now, I'm sorry, but I'm not a fan. And no, it's okay. You don't gotta be apologized about that. I mean, it's one of the things where we're all being transparent here. Yo, my man Andre's popped on. What's popping, fam? How you doing, brother? You don't gotta be a fan. And that's what I was actually gonna say. I see what he's trying to do. I see where he's trying to go in with it. I am not a huge fan myself. Y'all are just hard critics. I mean, I love y'all.
The beat was my favorite part of it, personally.
I mean, if the beat was your favorite part of it, I think that's the problem. So, because part of the problem was that he didn't even buy the beat. He didn't even pay for the beat. You heard the tag in the beginning. Exactly. You heard the tag in the beginning. So, if the beat was your favorite part, know that you could probably go on SoundClick and download the beat for free with the tag and listen to it.
It does have a familiarity to it. I feel like I've heard
it's one of the things where I see where he was going with the track. I see everything he wants the track to be. I can see the vibe of the kind of artist that he's developing himself to be. Like, I see all that. Maybe just a little bit more time with it. Like, and then it wasn't, yeah, SARS not needed. Yeah, you're right. But it's like one of those things where, like, I just feel like it needs. I feel like it needs more development. It didn't sound really finished. Really sound finished to me.
Yeah,
I'm a huge lyric fan. And what I mean by lyric fan, I mean like, what are you saying? Like, what is your message you're trying to get across? Like, I get the song's called. It was Lovesick we listened to, right?
Lovesick, yeah.
So I get the song is called Lovesick. Why are you lovesick? What did you go through? What happened? Like, right now, all I know, I need way more. You know what I mean? Because, like, no one can connect with the, we can't connect with the song if we don't get the background story. If we're getting, you know, if we're getting shallow lyrics on like, this is how I feel and I'm in the right to my feelings and no one feels the way I do. All right, then that means you're on your own and I can't connect with you. So I can't connect with the song. You know what I mean? So like, you need a little bit more in order to be able to connect with those kind of things. So yeah, man.
Yeah, I agree. I think that I see where he's going with the track, right? I think I see the appeal. I think it kind of tailors a little bit more to like the Lil Uzi sound right now that's kind of hot. So again, I see the appeal. But, I don't think it's for me.
But hold on. And I have done this live and direct with people, so that's to you, right? Making me be a savage. But anyways, even Lil Uzi gives you more. I will say he gives you more. Like, well, there's some tracks that he has that knock, that bump, that are smooth. Like, they give you more. And the thing about it is that there's nothing wrong. I'm not even jumping on the, like, there's nothing wrong. Like I said, I like commercial music. So I could vibe with something like this 100%. But they, it's just like, I wasn't given anything to vibe on it. You know what I mean? Like,
it needs to be way more fleshed out.
It needs to be restructured, rebuilt. Like, you know, there's a lot of things we could tear apart in terms of that song. But obviously, before we go any further, this is based off opinion. You know, this is based off my personal opinion. And, you know, it's going to change based off person to person. So it's going to be whatever at the end of the day. But
some people could really love it. That's fine. I mean,
I don't think it's a
bad song. I just think it has its limitations.
Right. But this is one of the things that we have to do first of all, as artists, we're putting ourselves out there. So we're putting ourselves out to the public to be judged. So that's going to be the first thing that we need to do. The second thing is going to be is like, you know, we got to do this more often. We got to be more honest and open about how we feel on things and not worry about, oh, man, this person's going to think I'm hating because I'm not with the song. No, I could rock with you as a person. We could be cool. We can go get drinks. We can go get some steaks, whatever it is. If you're vegan, we can have vegan food. I saw my boy on here earlier. You know what I mean? But like, it's just one of the things where like, if I'm not rocking with it, I'm not rocking with it. And if there's a reason why, there's a reason why. And if you want to take those things and go and develop it and switch it and change it and you know, make it more you. I'm not even saying change, but I'm saying make it more who you are. Then that's one thing. You know, I got a small circle, which I always take music and I'm always tossing it out there and being like, yo, what do you think? And if you think that this chat is savage, take your songs and put it in my small circle. That's savage. That is a savage circle. I mean, you know, right now, I got boys that be like, I don't fuck with it.
Well, that's like, why? You need that, though. You need that.
And I'll be like, why? They'll be like, because this is off. This doesn't sound right. This is this. Or some of them like, yo, this just doesn't sound like you. And I'm just like, they're like, I can hear this person on it, but it doesn't sound like a UB, you know? And I take that feedback. I grow with it. And then, like, I either change a few things or sometimes I don't. And because I rock with it, and that's where the growth and opportunity comes from. You know, as the artist, you gotta choose, like, but you have to be open and receptive to be able to grow and change things. So, yeah, man.
No, I'm with you, man. And like, same with us, you know, even with our podcast, like our circle, like I always take either criticism or constructive criticism or any kind of feedback about like, you know, what we're doing, you know, and that's how we've grown, right? It's just like, because if we had stayed stagnant the way we do it, like stuff like this wouldn't be happening. So definitely one of the things where you have to take the constructive criticism is always important, no matter what you're doing, you know what I mean? Or, you know, always. Whether it's podcasting or music or anything like that. So, you know, Lil Nicky, I think, you know, he has some work to do, but that's okay. Nothing wrong with that. You know what? He might have a fan base that likes this and rocks with this, and that's fine. So. New sweatshirts are fire. Yo, good look, Sean. I appreciate you. Yeah, just a side note, we have our store. I'm actually wearing a little t-shirt here. So if you guys, I'll announce this now. I'll put it on a post pretty soon. But the next blog post that's going to come out, we're going to be putting a promo code for any of our merch, all right, for 50% off during this coronavirus time. And I'm not sure what we're going to do with the proceeds yet, but I'd like to try to put something towards, you know, people that are working on the front lines and things like that. So I'll be on the lookout for 50% off merchandise, and some of the proceeds we definitely want to try to push to some, you know, I haven't decided yet, kind of figured out where I want to put the money, but definitely somewhere to people that right now need it, whether it's kind of nurses on the front line to, you know, get masks like that or whatever. So, be on the lookout for something like that, no doubt.
That'll be dope. That'll be dope, man.
I saw you laughing. Peeped it.
Well, I'm laughing because my boy said, he said, me. He goes, Z, peep this for me. Z. I'm like, don't put that out. Me, why? Z, it's not the one.
Not the one.
But yo, like,
but that's real. That's real.
But I mean, it's, yeah, you know, I am just that way. But see, that's the beauty between the friendship and brotherhood that Cam and I have. But also, I want to say it's also the beauty of like kind of like the respect for the music that we have is because like there is so much honesty there of like, yo, like, you know, he's told me straight up, he's like, yo, Z, like, change this, or you got to try this, or grow out of this, or do this. And I'm like, I don't know. He's like, yo, but you got to try it before you knock it. You know, like, there's so many different things, and it's like, that's what helps to the growth. So, like, but also what makes it fun. That's what makes it fun. What makes it fun is being able to try new things and do different things. And that's part of the reason why I've crossed genres of doing hip hop, of doing pop, of doing the R&B song 3 AM, which I mean, you know that, and then also doing Afro music now, and doing dancehall music, and doing all those things, like crossing different genres. That's what makes it fun, is being able to step out and grow as an artist to be able to express yourself in multiple ways. So, yeah, man, that's what's up.
Kid just keeps it 100 on here. I freaking love it.
Yeah, man.
I got two more tracks here. You ready for them?
I am ready for them. I'm ready. Let's get it. You know what I mean?
This next one is called All We Do by Oh Wonder.
All We Do.
By All.
All. And is Do spelled D-U-E or D-O?
It's just D-O.
I gotta ask now. I have to ask. Because, you know, what we've been D-O. Experiencing. You know, All We Do. And who's the artist? Oh Wonder. Gotcha.
All right.
All we do is hide away. All we do is hide away.
Facts. It's also for life, man.
Yeah.
Yo, I really like this. I really like this.
Billie Eilish, yeah.
I don't want to be the right way round. I find paradise on the ground.
So you know who sent this in?
Oh.
So it's actually my mother. So she like loves these guys. So she's
word?
To us
shows. Yo, listen. This is
Dia Hampton on Instagram. She does poetry and all that good stuff. So definitely take a shot at her poetry. It's good stuff. She's a good writer. This song is fucking gorgeous, man.
Yeah, it's beautiful. And like you know I'm a fan of piano, man. Like yo, like it's so smooth. Like I'm gonna like I got them on my. I got them locked in here, so I'm gonna revisit this.
Shout out to mom, Gianna. Thank you. Shout out, Gianna. Thank you for being here. And she's a nurse, so big round of applause for what she's doing right now.
Yeah.
Seriously, you and all the nurses.
Yes.
You guys are the heroes right now. Like no bullshit.
Facts.
Yeah, dude, this song's freaking beautiful, man. It's I've heard this a couple of times. I was. Definitely wanted to send it your way, see what you thought.
It's beautiful. It's 100% beautiful. But I, again, like we had it. I love different genres. I love different things, but this is just so, it's such a smooth thing. You know what I mean? Like, and this is a song, that I would play, like, definitely a day today, rainy vibes throughout the house, chill, listen to it. I'll listen to it at night. I'll listen to it in the morning. If I'm having a quiet morning going to work, if I'm coming back and I just had like, it's a song that kind of, that's just the way it was recorded and produced, it just helps you like release.
Mm-hmm.
And it just helps helps you think.
Absolutely.
So I vibe with it, man.
Heavy. No, I love this track, dude. And like, I think somebody mentioned Billie Eilish. I'm a huge Billie Eilish fan. It was one of my first blog posts that I did. I think that she's absolutely fantastic. And I would think that that's a similar vibe here. This track.
It is similar, but believe it or not, I'm not a big Billie Eilish fan.
No kidding.
I am not a big Billie Eilish fan. It's a similar vibe, but I'm not. But it's crazy because I rocks with this.
Well, there's some things Billie Eilish does that are very out there, but I like that. I like the more weird stuff personally. That's just kind of me, but.
But
she has songs.
It could be different. Well, it don't gotta get weird, but it could be different, you know.
Fair enough. Last track we have tonight is No Slice. This is from Wally Zoo, I believe. That's Z-O-O, so not Z-E-W or anything weird like that. Just Zoo. And I went back and forth with this guy. I think a couple of months ago. I can't remember quite off the top of my head. I want to say he's from Rhode Island, but don't quote me. I think he's from Providence, Rhode Island, if I'm not mistaken.
You said Wally Zoo, right?
Wally Zoo. The song's called No Slice.
Two L's, one L, one E, five
Two
I's.
Two L's.
Gotcha.
Wally, yeah. Not like the movie, like that animated movie, Wall-E. It's like Wally with a Y.
Gotcha.
Yeah. Thank you, bro. Yeah, good. Got it. All right. No Slice. See, Zach, I actually disagree with you. I listen to Billie Eilish alone versus not on the radio. So interesting. This is why music is so cool. Really is. A little bit of a build up here.
No slice, no slice, no slice, no slice, no slice, no slice. I'ma be a greedy motherfucker with the whole damn life. No slice, no slice, no slice, no slice, no slice, no slice. I'ma be a greedy motherfucker with the whole damn life. Now I make it be over one of something. You had the chance, now you been so follow on the grim. I'm on my big old flow, all I really want is go. I share my vision, I really don't think you listen, no. Nobody looking at me, I'm seeing the press of the gas. I made a promise to myself, never back down. I ain't the first hit, y'all just got me starting now. No slice, no slice.
I don't like it, personally.
Yeah, I'm a put Z on some Russ.
I have not since some of his older stuff. I'm not a huge fan of Russ.
Not a fan of Russ.
Not really. Russ. He's okay. I don't mind him. He's okay.
I like the beat of this song. I also have to go back. I'm gonna have to listen to it because I think you paused up a few times or whatnot. But
my bad. Maybe my connection was
bad. No, you're good. You're good. It happens. We don't all got T-Mobile. It's one of those things where. We're going to go back to that fast rap, and I could not catch a lot of what he was saying.
No.
But again, I have to attribute a lot of it to, like, I didn't get to hear the whole track. But it's something, sure. I mean, the beat goes. I like the beat, but I don't know. I really don't know.
Wasn't for me.
So you would like Past Life by Trevor Daniel Moore.
The hook was basic. But
no, yeah, the hook did not cap capture me at all.
It didn't. It didn't grab me. Like, I need a song within the first 30 seconds to kind of grab me, or I'm gonna probably move on and get like, you know.
Yeah. Yeah. Like.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm already over it.
Yeah.
You know, we had the relationship and it ended. You know.
I am. He seems a good dude. Like I said, I went back with the fourth of them a couple of like maybe I guess a couple months ago. He seemed like a good, good dude, but. You know,
yeah, no, he's not a reflection of just the song or what I feel towards the song. I mean, he could probably mad shows, probably a great dude, but yeah, no.
Yeah, the song I wasn't a huge fan of personally. We got time for one more, I think. I got somebody wanted Zach Past Life by Trevor Daniel and someone else approved. So let's check this one out. This will be the last one.
I'm starting to be honest with my happiness. I know I'm bad at this. And I don't wanna settle in my sadness. I know it's a habit of mine. Perfect, perfect. Mind me, I ruined it before it began. Oh, last night was a lesson. Cats that got me here, like you can never figure me out. Last night was a lesson, was a lesson. I never let you figure me out. Sitting here talking to myself, taking all I used to, only thing I'm used to. Last night was a lesson, my cats said, oh, gave me what I wanted when I needed it.
I like it. It's a blend. It felt like a blend of different kinds of genres on there too. It felt like he was touching, you know, a little bit of pop, a little bit of.
Yeah, I definitely liked the build. Like the song. This is what I'm talking about. Like the first minute, it grabbed my attention because you could hear what he was saying, right? Like you could obviously, like he was very clear. It was catchy. Like I liked the guitar there. I thought that was kind of like the backbone of the beat. I like this song a lot, man.
Yeah, really do. Yeah.
And then I loved when like it got to that build. And then, you know, hit. I was definitely a big fan of this track right now. Definitely.
Yeah, man.
Zach, you are 3 for 3. Good job, buddy. Proud of you.
I like that. I like that a lot.
Me too. Good song. Yeah. What are you listening to these days, Zafir?
Man, I'm listening to a lot of different things. But if we're gonna vibe out to something, I'm gonna give this one to my boy Paul Solo, who jumped on right now. I'm gonna give you this one, Paul Solo. So, you know, Troubling.
We gotta play
that's
that.
A vibe.
Well,
that's a vibe.
He played that live at the show.
Yeah, he did. I'm saying if you're gonna ask me to nominate a song for right now, I'm gonna give Paul Solo this one right here. I'm gonna say Troubling.
Troubling? Let's do it.
Say Troubling.
Troubling. Paul Solo. Let's do it. How does he spell Solo?
He got it with a dollar sign.
Ah, that's why it's not coming up. Ah, got it. All right, let's do it. I remember this. He went at the very end, right? Right after you played the one song? Yeah.
Yeah.
Haven has talked about him before. Shout out Have.
Yeah, shout out to my man Have, obviously, yo. Like, yeah, but.
Troubling, 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 troubling.
Right? Right? Let's get it. Go ahead, yo, cut that. See, that's what I'm talking about, man. It's like it's a vibe, man. Paul already knows I mess with the music heavy, and I honestly love what he's doing there, but like that's a vibe, man. And the thing about it is it's like
I like the dance hall. I feel like it's hard to do good dance hall. Like it's not easy.
It's not easy, but also you gotta understand, like this song flirts on the line of dance hall, of Afrobeat. It flirts on that line. I mean, you always gotta know Paul to know that, you know what I mean, as well too. But like it vibes and he does it well. But this is a through and through, man. Like I'll put it like this, and I'll be 100% about it. If this came from a major artist, this song would be a number one hit. I have no doubt about that. If it came from any other major artist, well, being that if he took the song and he sold it to a major artist, it would be a hit because it's a hit song.
I think it would too.
It's a vibe.
Yeah, I could easily hear this on the radio. Once we're out of quarantine, right? We're all like at the pool or at the beach or whatever. This is like the vibe, I think. Like just kind of.
Yeah, it's. Oh man, you, this is. Gonna... You, it's yeah.
Not
yeah,
a radio, we, radio we, listener, but
said, I we need agree with that we need more of this on the radio. 100%. Yeah, dog. I'm telling you, it's a vibe, man. That's my man Paul. He was in the chat earlier. I don't know if he's still here, but that's Paul Solo. So make sure y'all go check him out. You know what I mean? And can't say I never did anything for you, Paul. All right.
Well, hey, we'll get him on a Boston artist review, no doubt, because I know he's a Boston guy. So because Haven came on the show and he talked about him as well. A guy to definitely look out for. So yeah, no, I like that track. I remember him doing it. The whole place was vibing with him. I remember he was walking around and shit. People were like grooving with him. It was good stuff, man.
Yeah, man, definitely.
Good song.
Definitely.
Dude, yo, thank you so much for doing this, man. This was awesome.
Oh, yeah, it was fun.
This was a lot of fun, bro.
It was dope. You know, besides you kicking me off, yeah, that was, everything else was dope.
You still with that? You can't hold grudges like that.
I can't. I'm a work in progress, man. I'm a work in progress.
Aren't we
you
all?
I can't. Yeah, you know, I'm just not.
It's quarantine time. I feel like everyone's a little bit more on edge. You know what I mean? The anxiety is just heightened just a little bit.
You know? Nah, I'm like this 24/7. This is just me. You know what I mean?
Follow this man, officially Zaf Fear. Definitely tune in next week for the Boston Artist Review episode.
Hold on. I want to put this out. Thank you for submitting your music, man. We appreciate you.
Absolutely.
We appreciate you. And thank you for being open and receptive and willing for any kind of feedback. I'm grateful for that. And you know what I mean? Because that's something that helps growth. It helps everything else. And it's honestly people and artists like yourself that help all of us grow. Artists like myself and everyone else. So thank you for being willing. Thank you for offering that. And definitely grateful.
To just kind of send it out and not know, you know, how it was going to be received. So, yeah. I think we're going to do more of these for sure. And we'll definitely have you back on, like I said, to do this because this was awesome. So
yeah, man. Yeah, definitely. It'll be dope, man. This was fun. I enjoyed it a lot, man.
This was a lot of fun. Absolutely. Yeah, if anybody that, you know, missed any of this, we'll definitely be posting this somewhere. Like save all this, throw it on YouTube. We're going to definitely throw it on New app out there that Zafir and I both are now partnered with. It's called Firework. Make sure to follow us on those, that platform as well. Tune into your
live. Don't hold on. Don't jump over it, man. You gotta sit on that for a while, man. We got offered to be brand ambassadors for a whole new app that's coming out, man. That is huge. That is something that we are humbled for, and it's awesome. So for any of y'all who do not have it yet, go download Firework.
And follow
this man. Follow me on Firework. We both got offered to be brand ambassadors on it, so we're creating tons of content just for Firework TV. It's incredible, and I'm telling y'all, it's probably going to be. Like I said, I love the app. I genuinely love the app.
Genuinely,
it's everything that it's like. I like that whole reveal feature. You can turn it. You can see everything on it. It has that whole kind of like TikTok feel to it a little bit, but not TikTok. So I'm a huge fan of it, dog. I love the app. I definitely say download it. Follow us on it. It's humbling to be asked to be a brand ambassador for anything like that. You know, so like, yo, sit on that for a while. You know what I mean? You gotta enjoy that. Don't walk past that part. You know what I mean? Let's celebrate that for a second.
Congratulations, no, it's a big thing. I mean, you know, I'm not trying to make that that wasn't the point of this, but I absolutely agree with you. Like that is, and like a Snapchat also invested a hefty amount into that app. So I think it's going to be the next big thing too, for sure. And like you said, definitely blessed to be a part of, you know, their family and their, you know, partners with them. It's really, really a cool opportunity for not only us, but to really kind of push a new app. So go make an account, follow us on there. I, like I said, and Zafir said, we genuinely like the app a lot. The reveal
factor. I'm actually on that app most of my day, actually, now. Yeah. Now I'm on the app most of the day, so
it's solid.
That's what's up.
Did a lot, yeah. So, yeah, man. New episode out, Boston Artist Review. It is out now, all right? Make sure to check that out. And, playlists will be available on Spotify. And
but I still have my most current song out, 3 a.m., so if y'all haven't heard that, please go check that out. Follow me on Spotify. I'm actually going to be doing a giveaway for all my fans and supporters for me saying thank you. So you guys are actually going to hear it first here inside the chat, because I'm actually going to do a story as soon as I get off the chat, letting everybody else know. But it's just going to be a giveaway for me saying thank you so much. I can't give you guys a gift card, but I can send you guys small cash prizes. So it's really simple. All you got to do is make sure you have a PayPal account. Make sure you have a Spotify account. Both of those are free. Then you follow me at Spotify. Snap it. Tag me on Instagram. I'm going to throw your name on a hat. We're going to go live. I'm going to pull it out, and I'm going to send you money. That's it. That's how this is going to work. Real simple. It's real simple. That's all you got to do. The more times, every day you tag me, your name goes in the hat more. So you get more chances to win that cash prize every day, once a day. I'm going to throw your name in that hat more. But thank you again for having me, man. I appreciate it. Listen, it's always a dope time. It's always, always, always a dope time. It's always fun. We got to do this more live streams. I think this is like the third time I did a live stream.
This is my first. I've never done one. So feel honored.
I am honored.
You should be. Yeah. Don't hold that grudge no more, bro. On me.
I'm going to let the grudge go, man. I'm going to let the grudge go.
I allowed you to be the first. Like, I allowed you to have this experience with me.
And it was a dope experience for us, the fans, and everybody here, man. It was a good time.
Well, anybody that participated, like, this was awesome. Thank you guys so much. We'll definitely do another one of these, maybe even make it a weekly or a bi-weekly thing. We'll kind of figure out how we want to do this. But, you know, thank you guys so much for, you know, kind of tuning in and giving us, you know, like I said, I know we give you guys so much music and we recommend things. But, you know, music is, of course, a thing to be shared. And we obviously, I walked away from some new music. Rod Wave
is the wave for tonight on this chat. Hands down, no question about it. I also want to say everyone was actually pretty active in the chat too. So thank you for that, because this actually makes it a lot better when people are like talking back. So that way, you know, we can see everyone engage and respond, everything like that. It's the whole point to it. You know what I mean? It's to connect. So thank you. Thank you.
It's all love, everybody. Seriously. We appreciate it. So definitely, guys, like I said, check out some promo coming soon for Zafir's listening party, which will happen in a few weeks. We'll give you guys an exact date for that. And yeah, make sure you tune in to our next blog post, which will have a promo code for our merch, right? Like I said, I'm wearing one of the brand new t-shirts we have here, right? We just got a brand new vendor. They came out amazing. 50% of the funds we're going to get, we're going to donate to a coronavirus fund of some sort, hopefully helping nurses and, you know, the medical field. And then, of course, as Zafir said, look into his Instagram post for the announcement for his cash giveaway. And yeah, guys, thank you so much for tuning in. This was so much fun. Zafir, appreciate you.
Yes, I'll sir. Appreciate you, fam.
Of course. We'll see you guys soon. Go listen to the brand new episode, Boston Artist Review, out now on Spotify, Apple, SoundCloud, Google Play, anywhere you hear podcasts. Go check that out. This is Zafir. This is Mike. Thank you for tuning in. Good night, everybody.
Easy.